Welcome to this edition of the 411 Talk Zone Radio Show. My name is Leon Jones. Tonight's topic, former President Obama is ready to reclaim political fame. Former President Obama is ready to reclaim political fame. After taking a well-deserved vacation, former President Barack Obama is ready to make his return to politics, and it's safe to say that the world is ready to welcome him back with open arms. Now, according to Politico, former Attorney General Eric Holder has been in talks with the former president to figure out ways for him to get involved with a new Democratic Redistricting Committee, which aims to help the Democratic Party win back state legislative seats in the 2018 election and beyond. Now, prior to leaving office, Obama had asked Holder to chair the committee, and now he's ready to be more of a visible part of the effort. It's coming. He's coming, Holder said, and he's ready to roll. The mission of the NDRC is to build a targeted state-by-state strategy that ensures Democrats to produce fairer maps in 2021, and that's based on redistricting. So the Democrats, of course, can have a chance to win all the state and Senate legislative seats, and from there, they'll be able to enter the national scene, and that's going to eventually propel them in a running for national office. And I'm talking about the Congress and the Senate and President. Now, in particular, the committee hopes to combat Republican gerrymandering by providing legal resources to fight the better maps, launch targeted ballot initiatives, and campaigning to win critical state elections that start redistricting. At this time, it is unclear what role Obama will play in helping the NDRC, which is, again, the new National Democratic Redistricting Committee, to achieve these goals. But one can assume that the committee will likely use its popularity with young voters to help re-energize the Democratic Party. And this is a battle for our democracy, Holder said. The notion that people are denied their ability to cast a meaningful vote is inconsistent with who we say we are, and it's inconsistent with what we say our democracy is about. Now, first, let me break this down. The United States of America is not a democracy. In fact, we're a corporation. We're a republic. We are a democratic republic. That's why we have a checks and balance system. Now, again, this is the Democrats crying the blues. They still can't accept that L. Hillary Clinton lost the election. She was a bad candidate. Now, I'm not saying that everything Trump will do is going to be agreeable. However, I feel that the country can be put back in our economic favor. He's trying. But the problem is, you have so many Democrats who are going to go out and have these meaningless protests, and the country is not going to have you back. Regardless, Obama had 8 years to turn his country around. He did nothing for black people. He helped gays. He helped women out. But black people, he did not. Of course, black people voted for Obama in 2008 because he was black. Let's just be honest. Everybody in the black community wanted to see the first black president. Let's understand something, that Obama was raised by a white mother. He's black. He's not black, but he looks more black. That's fine. And I do respect the office of the presidency. Obama is a charismatic guy. I respect that he went to Harvard Law School. I respect that his wife, they became successful. And that makes me feel good as an African-American, because when you put your mind to something, you can be successful no matter what race you are, or what nationality, or sexual orientation. What I don't like is the Democrats are still trying to invoke their socialist ways into this country. They don't work. That's why Obama and his cronies in the Democratic Party lost. You cannot promise somebody something free without asking, well, who's going to pay for it? And that's the problem. What Obama needs to do is to take time off, go back, and relax. He had 8 years. But here's the problem. He's very narcissistic. He thinks he's running this country. Donald Trump is the 45th president. Donald Trump is going to take away some of your agenda. When Obama was in office, look what happened. Jobs really weren't created. They were part-time jobs. They weren't paying anything. The economy was basically slow. And I believe the numbers for unemployment were higher than what the government put out because you had people who stopped looking for work. So that excludes them from the unemployment numbers. Black people, I believe that we had a 16% unemployment rate, higher than everybody else. When Obama was in office, he passed Obamacare, which nobody read the bill. It raised a lot of premiums. In fact, if you had a PPO working for somebody, it could be as high as $600 a month. Now, that depends on if you're single or had a family. His policies are more or less redistribution of wealth. That never works because what happens is you have individuals who are living off the fat of the land. And it's not just for the poor amongst us. It is for the rich. Obama believes that government should run every aspect of our lives. That's why he wanted to tax everything. When you have public schools, well, the liberals, they don't fix the problem. They throw money at the problem. That's the same as if I go to a bar, I already have a problem. But I drink bottle after bottle after bottle after scotch. That problem is not going to go away. And what's going to happen at the end of the day, I'm going to have a second problem. Although, be it on a temporary side, it's still a problem. What the Democrats need to do is come up with realistic solutions instead of thinking on a partisan or emotional front. Liberalism has stuck this country in debt for the last past 50 years, but it got worse in the 90s, the 2000s, and the 2010s. You see, when it all first started under the Great Society program under Lyndon B. Johnson, well, you didn't feel the effects that much. There was a Vietnam War going on, and a lot of these liberals did not go to war. They didn't even sign up for the draft. In fact, they got to go to college to dodge the draft. And this is where all these policies come from. You had Cloward and Pivens in the 1960s. They were professors from Harvard University. What they wanted to do, they wanted to collapse the whole system. And what they had planned was this. Have everybody go down to the welfare office. Bankrupt the state's welfare offices. And then come up with a system of their own. That's socialism. And see, here's the problem with college. College teaches you these theories of Marxism. This is why you have so many dictators who sound charismatic. They have an intent of giving you something free. But in the long run, the leaders don't pay. It's the citizens who pay. Because their money is always tinkered with every day through high taxation. This is why York, they have problems. Certainly it sounds good that they have 6 weeks of vacation off, but if you look at the amount of money that they make for doing the same type of job that Americans do. They work much less and they get paid much less. But their whole government system is income wealth redistribution. That's socialism. Socialism doesn't work. Now, the United States has always believed in a free market system. Obama doesn't believe in a free market system. He wants redistribution of wealth. In fact, when he came into the office of the presidency in 2008, he was looked at as the great Messiah. Remember, he's not God, and you don't worship a man. You worship God. But he was as charismatic as a Pol Pot, a Mussolini, a Stalin, a Leningrad, and these other dictators like Fidel Castro by promising everybody the world. But the problem is, nothing is ever free. Somebody's going to pay for it. Now, Obama, his cronies want to take my money and give it to people who aren't producing anything. This is why they live these highfalutin lives, particularly in your bigger cities. These positions, and I'm not talking about the poor now, because welfare, if you really think about it, is basically 2% of the taxpayers' money. It really is. A lot of that money goes to the bureaucrats. Now, the only reason why they give welfare receipts, all the money that they hand them, is because they want the welfare receipts to become a voting bloc, which they are. I mean, if you're giving me something free, regardless of what the consequences are, most likely I'm going to take it. But it's easy to get the uneducated and fool them. All these protests that have come about during the Trump administration, I really believe have been funded by billionaire George Soros. Now, what you need to do, Donald Trump has cut the money off. That's right, cut the flow of the money off. If these thugs, and that includes Obama, if he goes out there and encourages destruction of property, you send him to jail. You charge him with racketeering. The RICO statute. See, once you cut the money off, then you cut the activity off. Now, it's nothing wrong with protesting. Protests should be peaceful. But I see a lot of these Democratic protesters going out there. They're destroying property. They're getting violent with people who aren't thinking on their level. They're trashing the cities by leaving trash all over the place. And I saw plenty of pictures of that from WSBT-TV in South Bend, Indiana. Saw it in Chicago. I want Barack Obama to be a leader and stop this madness from the Democrats. There's nothing wrong with having a strategy for making each and every district fair. We need a two-party system, because I don't want all Republicans running this country either. I don't want all Democrats running this country. This country was founded on checks and balances. But with Obama's popularity, I know what he's trying to do. He does want to reach out to the youngsters. Why? Well, it's easy to fool the youngsters because they're not educated anyway. In fact, most of the youngsters, what are they doing? They're back home living with their moms. They're not taught how to be men and women, because mama will allow them to come back home and stay as long as they want without having a job, without paying rent at home. But these kids can run in and out of the house when they want to, eat up the food, use the water, use the power. They can sass the mom, because when it comes to liberals, liberals don't believe in discipline. They believe in setting everything on a kumbaya type of stratosphere. Get your kids to like you. That's how they discipline children. They break up families. That's why their policies are no good. And again, if you look at the liberal record in your major cities, look what you got. High crime, welfare, high unemployment, bad schools, bad health. And this is proven because you look at all the greasy fast food restaurants that are coming in or that have come in to some of the poorer neighborhoods. When you utilize liberal policies, they're policies that don't make sense. They put a chokehold on the economy. And who makes all the money when liberals are in power? Liberals do. In fact, the wealthiest 1% are liberals. They don't want to see it. See, liberals don't produce anything but rhetoric, scare tactics. They get into your emotions. And people who are emotional are very irrational at thinking. And this is what liberals are. But Barack Obama stepping back in the political spotlight, it just enhances everything. A former president, look at George Bush. Once Obama got into office, you didn't hear from President George Bush anymore. But Obama, he thinks he's going to come out behind the scenes and run this country. President Obama, you had 8 years. Your health care bill stunk. 3,000 pages. And all you did, you rammed it through when nobody read it. You wanted to charge all these emission taxes. You raised the base price of cars because of all these environmental regulations. And this is what liberals do. They come out utilizing freedom for social issues. But are they really in the freedom? No, they're in the tyranny. And the worst person you could have in office is somebody who believes that government can run all of our lives. That's not how it works in the United States of America. Again, if you think I'm wrong, you go visit some of these countries, because I have been to Cuba. I've been over there in some of those African countries. Been to Italy. Government cannot run the economy because government wastes a lot of money. You look at all the infrastructure bills. Where's the money? The infrastructure is worse than it's ever been. You look at the ASCE report, and that's the American Society for Civil Engineers report. Under Obama, we had a chance. Now, granted, there's some rubber-legged Republicans who didn't hold their own either, because some of them are liberal. The bottom line, Donald Trump is president. You don't have to like it, but if you really want to do something, Democrats, support the president. Because at the end of the day, regardless of which side of the fence we're on, we need to come together instead of being divided. That's the problem. And the Democrats believe in partisan politics, because if they utilize their strategies by keeping us going back and forth, the left and the right, well, that only helps them. Why? Because you have professional victims. And with the Democratic policies, they control the rhetoric that goes on over the media, because basically the media is for the Democrats. You look at the Republicans, even with the Rush Limbaughs and the Sean Hannitys, the Michael Savages, their media is still much smaller than the Democratic machine. I mean, the Democrats own all the major cities' newspapers. They're in all of your educational institutions. This is where all the rhetoric is coming from, and not just in colleges and universities, but in your elementary schools, your middle schools, and your high schools. The bottom line, liberal politics also keeps society uneducated, because the educated people are a threat. And once you find out the game, well, these Democrats or these leftists want to find a way to get rid of you. told Mr. Obama, you want to be a real leader, support the President of the United States like you were supported. Now, granted, I told some of my Republican friends, respect the office of the presidency. George Bush respected you as a president. He also respected Michelle Obama, your wife. If you want to educate these youngsters, teach them about government. Don't teach them how to trash what you were part of and you benefited off of government. And you left these out there. Why should you control what is said? You talk about free speech. It's no free speech. It's your speech. The reason why you lefties want to control all the rhetoric because all of your platforms and all your propaganda makes no sense. You have no way to get to a solution. You know why? Because it's all in vote and emotion. Again, emotion clouds thinking. I don't know how many individuals who were on the left side started crying, got coloring books to make them feel better, walked out of schools. They walked off their jobs just to protest. See, the dumb thing about you liberals is when you walk out of school, you walk off a job because you don't like what's being said, there's a chance that you will lose your job. And that's not the Republicans' fault. That's your fault. So what I want to say to you, Mr. Obama, think about the consequences before you come back. Because not everybody is going to welcome you back. You just left office. Certainly, you've got book signings. Your books are going to sell. Because you were, at one time, the most popular man in the United States. Set the example for African Americans that they can grow because you did nothing for African Americans. But then again, that's also our fault because we didn't have a platform. We weren't well financed or organized like the gays were. At the end of the day, if you want to get America back together, you're going to have to compromise some of your dictatorial policies. They won't work. You look at all these actors who benefited off of everybody else, but they're claiming that they're oppressed. They're not oppressed. They might be high on drugs, but they're not oppressed. People like myself, I go to work every day. I'm not depressed, but I know I'm not in the elite class either. But what I do know is how this political machine works. It's a lot of money involved, and it's tough being out there in the real world when you have to work for something. But Mr. Obama, you don't have to work hard. You can go give a speech for $50,000 to $100,000 a speech. You are going to live good. Sit back and enjoy the real world. Go do your book signings. Start a radio program. You're in Chicago. If you really want to do something, help the people in Chicago. Because the city that you're from is a mess. And it's going to get worse. And guess who's doing the majority of the killing? Black folk. Black on black crime. Again, we keep doing that, we're going to eliminate each other. In other words, we're going to create our own gentrification. We don't need people like Margaret Sanger saying it or the Ku Klux Klan doing it because we're going to continue to do it. And see, your policies, they don't have anything to do with family. They keep us poor. And what the Democrats are marching for, they're really marching for nothing because it's not going to help you all. In fact, I see what you're doing, your intent, with your strategies. In the long run, you're going to lose in 2018. Because people don't forget. And you got to remember, next year is the 2018 election. And in some states, like mine, Indiana, you're not going to get Democrats to win in this state. You might do in New York, to do it in New York. You might do it in California. These Midwestern states? Oh, no. Look at what's going on now, Mr. Obama. You got 33 out of 50 governors who are Republican. It's because the Republican policies, for the most part, work. Look at John Kasich. He turned Ohio around. I don't agree with everything John Kasich says. But he's done an extraordinary job with Ohio. Look at Indiana. Indiana has its problems. But when it comes to running effective government, they were at the top. You look at all the Democratic states. Governor Rauner was a Republican in Illinois. He can't even pass a budget. Tom Wolf in Pennsylvania. They can't pass a budget. The problem is, Mr. Obama, you don't understand how the economy works, and you don't understand what it is to be in the real world, because you've had everything paid for by us, and that includes your college. I'm not saying that you didn't work hard, but we don't need you coming back into the limelight to try to disrupt this country. You had 8 years. You failed. So do us all a favor. Take a step back and enjoy your life. I respect that you were president, but it's time for Donald Trump to lead. And then if the Democrats can drum up enough support to get Donald Trump out in 2020, let the chips fall. But right now, Obama, you had your turn. It's time for Donald Trump to take the helm. And he's already done it. And he's done more for this country in less than 50 days in office than you did in 8 years. You remember that. And you remember, if you start some static out here by encouraging these Democrats to get violent, by destroying property and people, then you're going to hurt the Democratic Party's chances of ever regrouping to win any election. Remember, knowledge is power, but execution is how you get things done. And it's my commentary for this edition of the 411 Talk Zone radio show for this evening, Friday, March 3rd, 2017. You can tune in to the 411 Talk Zone radio show every Monday from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. on Blog Talk Radio. Guest call-in number is 215-383-5785. And if you like my videos, please share and subscribe to the 411 Talk Zone radio show right here on YouTube so I can continue to give you quality information for educational purposes from a professional and mature perspective. Now, on this channel, I don't engage in debates, controversial issues, or emotional issues, nor do I participate in drama or unnecessary bickering. What I do here at the 411 Talk Zone radio show, I educate. And what I am sharing with you is the information from my own experience and the information that I research. Because in order to make it in the real world, you need to have the tools. And once I give you the tools, you apply the tools. Because the real world is challenging. Mr. Obama, you might need some of these tools to understand how the real world works. Remember, knowledge is power. If you have a business, a topic, or YouTube channel that you would like for me to discuss on YouTube or Blog Talk Radio, please email me at lej6521@gmail.com. And if you'd like to leave a comment, because I love comments, leave it in the comments section under the video. But make sure that your comments are pithy, no bloviating, pettifogging, or filibustering if you wish to opine. Time for some shout-outs. Shout-out to Brother Tobias Orion. Like, share, and subscribe to his channel. Like, share, and subscribe to the Negrosphere. That's O'Shea Duke Jackson. Shout-out to Conscious Effort. Rashawn DeLay. Shout-out to his channel. Shout-out to Karen Kennedy. Sani Poo. Shout-out to Reg the Bad Guy from California. Shout-out to The Real Deal from Gary, Indiana. I got you, brother. Shout-out to Big Body Matt Coley. Matt, you're doing a fantastic job teaching your boss how to ride a motorcycle. Be safe. Wear your helmet. Shout-out to Brother Q Wilson. Q, you hadn't been up on YouTube. What's up? We need to see those Uber videos. Got people crying. They want to make money. And they want you to show them how to utilize Uber to make money. Shout out to the Healing Palace. That's by Felicia from Speedway, Indiana. If you want some good cooking, shout out to Mrs. G's Cooking Slow Green. Shout out to the Angry Man channel. Shout out to Paul DiMicardo. That's right, his name is Paul DiMicardo. Shout out to him. He's got good content on his channel. And again, as soon as I find some positive YouTubers who fit right in my demographic or who have good sense, I'm going to add them to my list of shoutouts, because in the black sector of YouTube, we have to support each other. And I'm talking about the individuals who are doing good work and making sense. And let me not forget Mr. J.R. Wisdom and Brother Ringo TV Raw. And that's it for this video. Till next time, my name is Leon Jones. Remember, please be gentle and respectful to each other, and have a wonderful and blessed night. Good night.